pathetic, dude. It's actually pathetic. So pathetic. Have a strat for Dancer? No, not really. It's all about positioning, basically. You just make sure you stand behind her back right leg and you're good. Oh, I knew as soon as he did that attack and then, like, it's so delayed on that side. And I didn't have any stamina left, so it didn't... That was actually pathetic. Oh boy. Positive. Thanks for the host, dude. How was your stream? Try rested coins? Yeah, I guess we'll do that this time. I'll get the ones after... right after Dancer. Oh, that was absolutely pathetic, man. See, just imagine if that happened on no upgrade. Like, that's 4 hours into the run, almost. Oh, just pathetic. Ooh. Dopamine, what's up, man? Thank you for the good luck. And positive thank you, dude. Just had the dumbest hit of all time, maybe. Okay, no, but it was bad. It was bad. Oh, I forgot all the stuff. Supposed to be in the middle of the fight? That does not throw me off at all. Oh, that was just pathetic though, man. At least it was my mistake though. That's kind of refreshing, to be honest. Play Zelda on 3DS dopamine? Alright, dude. Enjoy it, man. Yeah, I just went for the hit expecting death. But Nope. If I had Pontiffs on, it would have been death probably. But that was bad. I can't go for greed like that. Like, that was purely 100% my fault. So that's fine. I can deal with that. I just know now I can't go for greed in any situation on that fight. With the staff, yeah, I just wanted to test what the staff is going to be like on this run. Do a few attempts with it. See what it's like. Froz advised Susie while we were commentating to use that strat. Like, which strat? Like, just the staff in general, or like specifically half light? Yeah, the staff is allowed under the rules, though. I mean, I have the same problem. the exact same thing. So I don't know. I don't know. Irish chap, what's up, dude? Welcome, dude. What's the staff for? It's for a lot of things, man. Whoops. I can go through it all, too. Okay, so first time we use it is on deacons. So we use it first on deacons, then we use it on Frida Phase 2. That's actually really nice. Use it on Half-Light. Use it on... I guess Champion Gundyr we can use it too. Champion Gundyr, Wyvern. Who else? I guess that's it actually, after that. Or, and Gale. And Gale also. Knowing Frozen School, I did it, or didn't need the staff. Yeah, no, I kind of feel the same, but if I get no upgrade run, I feel like that doesn't really even matter. Which I will eventually. Alright, positive. See you later, man. Have a good sleep, and thank you for the hosting. But even, like, even if you have that issue with it, like, it's... I don't know, maybe, like, what I could do on this run is just use the staff and not use it for, Half-Light. Like, that is an option. But it's like... You could use that same logic somewhere else too. Like, so say there's a strat for, like, say the fire witch strat or the gargoyle strat, for example. Like, I could go like, okay, they didn't use it on this run. They didn't use it when they got their run. So, like, I feel bad using it on my run. Like, it's kind of different when you look at a strat like that. Even though it's just like all it is a different way of doing things. Like, and the goal of good strats is to make things easier. Same logic for princes. I don't use the princes strat on this run. Or the cheese or whatever. It's not really a need for it. The fight goes too fast. On no upgrade though, I might use it because I've gotten memed way too many times there. I don't know, but I still kind of feel like... Nah. I don't like it that much. It's just so good though. And it's just the fact that it's there, that it's like, it's an option that I have, because I'm probably gonna get the storytellers no matter what on this run now. And it's just so easy. But who knows, if I do eventually get this run at some point, then it could be without the cheese on Half-Light. Yeah, Storytellers, Jax. All my runs have PP1. Yep, that's true, man. Whoa! Did I not hit B there? I swear I hit B. That was weird. Yeah, like what I'm thinking I might do is like use the storyteller staff, but just not use the half-light strat. So like all the little uses that the storytellers gives, like I can use. And then just not like use it for deacons as well. And it wouldn't be an issue if half-light just wasn't such a significant boss on this run. Like if there wasn't all the half-light hype, then it would be fine. Like, as deacons, we do kind of a cheese on this run for deacons. And no one really cares because it's deacons, right? Like, deacons don't matter at all. Do the halfway cheese. I will if we get to them on this run. Like, today, but I might not. I might just do the parry strat. Like, and the thing is, like, even if I do an SL1 run, I can still do the halfway cheese on that. Technically. Rip all firebombs. Capra firebomb cheese? Yeah, but that's different though, because it's Capra demon. Like, it's not. It's kind of like how I do deacons though. Like, deacons on this run with storytellers, it makes it a guarantee fight. And it's not like, it's because deacons and Capra demon, they're not really significant. But half-light is significant, and like that's actually a big topic. Like, half-light's the hardest boss in this run without the storyteller staff, and the easiest with it. Like, in a big portion of the difficulty on this run comes from half-light. Capra would be a hard boss if it wasn't cheesed outside the room. I mean, I don't know. Deacon strat without counting? I don't think you can do it, man. Yeah, I guess I'll explain the deacon strat when we get there. I'm kind of convincing myself to not use it on this run and just do the normal parry strat. Like, I know I can do the parry strat. I know I can do that. No one had a good strat for him. Now he's not hard. Yeah, that is true, actually. Yeah, you're right. But also, like, if the half-light strat wasn't cheesy, then it'd be fine. Right? Like, so it's not only that there's, like, a good half-light strat that is very easy and consistent, it's that it's just cheesy now, right? And like before, they didn't cheese him. You can do it without cheesing, so. Like, because I would consider the halfway try to cheese. That's kind of why I don't like it. Like, on the no upgrade run, like, we have to do that, so it's fine. And like AI manipulation, don't use any skulls. Well, the thing with skulls is that it's intended, right? Like, skulls are meant to be used. Hmm. Burn, what's up, dude? We're just having a thoughtful discussion on whether the halfway chi should be used when it doesn't need to be. I don't know the answer. I don't think there is an answer. Splatter, what's up, dude? Only lock on what they see. It's kind of a gray area almost, because it's not a full out cheese. Like, it's not like you're outside the boss room kind of thing. It's not that severe. It's using something that, like, is programmed in the NPCs. Like, see, the thing is, if Half-Life didn't start to move, like, so you guys know the strat, if you're familiar with it, when you cast it, Half-Life begins to move and, like, move back and forth, like, very, like, kind of, it looks really glitchy. If that didn't happen, then I think the strat would be, it would look a lot better. I don't know why it happens. It has nothing to do with the strat actually working, I don't think. But yeah, it doesn't look that good. Yeah, burn the poison. The poison strat on Half-Light. Like, it's not like the run the run's that much easier with it. It's just one thing becomes more consistent. I don't know. But it does take something away from the run, I'd say. There's no right answer to this, basically. That's why it's so friggin' hard. There's no correct answer. Like, I wouldn't be wrong if I did the cheese, and I wouldn't be right if I did the cheese, and I wouldn't be wrong if I did it normally. I guess, yeah, like, I don't know. Like, and I do have the skill to pull off the half-light strat, like, consistently, too, with parries. Like, that's how I did it when I was first going for this run, and I did it pretty successfully. Ethics of no hit. Well, that's exactly what this is, actually. But it's not about what other people think, it's about how I feel about the run. And whether I think it's like I do think something would be taken away if I did the strat. Hopefully Frost didn't do it. Yeah. Actually, should not have used two there. Whatever. Ask myself this: if I got the run with the cheese, would I be satisfied? No, that is exactly what I'm. That's what I'm going through right now in my mind. That's exactly what I'm going through. And I don't know, because I haven't done it yet. much do I care about this run? The no upgrade is the... That is true, actually. Yeah. That is very true. Like, this run almost means nothing compared to the no upgrade. Like, it's not like... For example, it's not like if I get this run, then I'm immediately gonna be... like a well-known no-hit runner. Like, that's not the case at all. Knock this off and move on. That's I actually like that way of thinking. I go for the runs that I like doing more, like higher priority runs. Yeah, because the no upgrade run, if I do that, like, that's what I'll be known for, probably. Right? Okay, I think it's settled. We're gonna use the strat. We're gonna do it, and we're gonna do this run as fast as we can. Minimum required to pass. Done the best with your time. I guess so. Five.
Ashen one.
Pretty.
Was very. Farewell, Ashen.
Get the storytellers already? No, we get it right before Cathedral. It's actually kind of funny, the ethics of no hitting. That's kind of... Like, that's what this is, basically. Where there is no correct answer. Okay, we're gonna have to buy firebombs when we get back to Shrine. All this being said, though, we still have to get to Half-Light. Like, we still need to get to that point. So, and there's like a whole other 3 hours and 10 minutes of gameplay to get to that point, so, or to like worry about other than Half-Light. It's a weapon art? No, it's not. That's not the issue. That's not the issue at all. Like, I think the storyteller staff is completely allowed. Like, I use it on this run, regardless of Half-Light. It's just like it's a cheese, and that's what we're using on Half-Light as of right now. And that's the issue. And how it can be done without cheesing. Okay. Like, I think everyone's already accepted storytellers is not it's not magic. Like, it's, you're not. Like, it's just a weapon art, so that's fine. Use it on your run for sure. Yeah, no, it is a weapon art. That's not... I don't think there's any issue with that whole thing. I'm missing 3 damage. See if this still works. I don't know if it will actually. Or if I have enough stamina. Rune attack. That was aggressive. Cheesing kind of a broad statement. Also kill the fire demon straight up. It's not as consistent. Yeah, that is true. It is true. Like, it's just how, like, you have to, I think of something that plays a part in it is how significant is the cheese that you're doing? Like, how much of an impact does it actually make on the run? Like, because we do the Deacon's cheese on this run. And that makes things probably more consistent than if we did the Half-Light cheese. It's just, like, it's earlier and, like, it's, so it's not as significant. That's why I think it's not as big of a deal. Okay, so what we're gonna do, we are moving this fight. Right there. We're gonna do it, we're gonna save the easy stuff till later. And we don't really need more souls at that point, so. Same with Bloodborne, is the Micklash. Poison knife cheese allowed? Okay, well, what about here? How about this? What about the orphan knife cheese? What about that one? Like, I've already made my decision about this one, but what about that cheese? Like, as in defense of the Half-Light one, like, I'd say that the orphan cheese breaks the AI even more than this one. And it's like a blatant cheese. Like, I wouldn't say this one's on the same level as that one, but it's a similar idea, though. Frozen? No, it should be frozen. I think we're good. Can we just refresh? People use the orphan cheese? They don't. In no hit runs, they don't do that cheese. But I would also argue Orphan's a lot more fair fight than Half-Light is. But I don't want that to be a reason. Not really valid. Yeah, so I think, so out of the three people that have done the all content Bloodborne, all Bosses Plus DLC, none of them have used the Orphan Cheese. Which you could technically do. Like, you're allowed throwing knives in the run and stuff, but I don't really know enough about the Micklash Cheese to know. Or to, like, say anything about that one. Like, I don't know how... Is that, like, a really significant cheese, though? Call Beyond, same goes for Half-Light. Well, from what I've heard, though, Call Beyond is, like, possible to dodge. Or impossible, like, almost impossible to dodge. But, like, Half-Light's fair. Like, Half-Light is a fair fight. Like, and you can do it consistently, too. Like, if you're perfect, you can do it 100% of the time. There's nothing like in Twin Princes where you can get hit by doing everything correctly. Like, you can play perfectly, but still get hit on Princes. Twin Princes, that is. And, like, Half-Light's not like that. If you play perfectly against Half-Light, you're gonna win. It's very dodgeable. I don't know, I have not had to dodge that move ever, so. Has, like, so out of all the people that have done the Bloodborne no hit any percent, has everybody used the poison knife thing? AI bugs out a lot. Well, see, I've had a run end at Half-Life one time where I did the firebomb thing. I threw a firebomb, he input red. But because there was like the stairs or something, there was something like that, he did a turn right before he did his poke. And so then I saw it and delayed the parry, but it was too much because he did a little turn. There's no way I can possibly predict that. Like, there's only way you're gonna parry that when he does like a turn like that is if you get lucky. It's just kind of like a random turn. Like, so he was sprinting at me to do the poke, and then he did like that. He like did a little turn and which like delayed it. And like, there's what can I do about that? And that's how a run ended at Half-Life because of that. And Half-Life's was in the same position that I had him in now, like second last boss. So I guess there is an aspect to that fight. Like, that was the first time I ever saw that. But I guess there is a chance that it can be unfair, but I don't know. Honestly, like, whatever, I've already made up my mind, so like, we're gonna do it on this run if we get to that point. And we are going to do it when we get this run. Just because this isn't really a run that I care about too much, to be honest. I would much rather get the no upgrade all content, or all boss plus DLC. Which I also have a one hit PB on, so. Just like, I want a little bit of a break from that right now. Like, and this run is a lot easier than that. A lot easier. Good run to have too. I guess so. Like, only three people have done this run, so. Which is three more than have done the no upgrade all content. Three more than the Pyro all bosses in DLC run. Yep. Couch is close to that though. Very, very close. And I think the thing that's stopping him from getting that might be just because it's so long. Like, because he gets so many consistent attempts, like, far. Just that the run's so long, I think. Oh, is there two underscores? This is a slow part of the run? Yeah, no, this is... Watch Aaron's clip. Can you send that again or, like, whisper it to me or something? I didn't see that. Yeah, this part of the run absolutely sucks. Like, this is one of the reasons why I hate this run. Like, don't like this as much. Like, it's so boring. Alright, comic, thanks, dude. I will watch that at some point. Did it get hit? No. No, I just do this part later. Okay, let's get one of those, and then actually I think that's all we need. The no bonfire run? I am definitely. And I think so, what I've heard is that when people do it, they allow themselves to use Homeward Bones to get back to Shrine, but then they just need to run through High Wall again. So yeah, like, we could do that. Okay, so we're not gonna have a black firebomb for the dog in Cathedral. isn't great, actually. High wall shit. Yeah, it kind of is. But it's like that should be fine. I'm not gonna forget the Pontiff Beast this time. Like, as long as we get on this run, as long as we get past the stairs before Dragon Slayer, like, we should automatically get to Frida. Or get to DLC 1. Hit by every enemy, but survive the attack. Deathless at the same time. Yeah, if no bonfire, no hit run is possible, which I mean it should be. That would take a lot of work. Like since I know you can go back to shrine on it, then like it is possible. And so, like, I would almost suggest, like, I would think that you go kill Abyss Watchers in Wolnir. You would have to go back to Shrine before you get to Deacons, because you need Alluring Skulls. I actually don't know. I don't know about that run. To Wolnir, no upgrades above us. Well, that's doable. You can do Wolnir. Oh, that was so close. Yeah, it's just you'd have to run through the swamp again, which I guess wouldn't be that bad, would it? Like, actually, that would be very manageable. How do you do Sage? Yep, that's a great question. But I feel like you go back to Shrine before Sage. Like, so you, like, kill Wolnir, Homeward Bone back to Shrine, level up, sell your souls, level up your weapon, and then it would be super easy to do Sage. Because you can parry, and what, like, even if you have, like, just a +4, you can do it, which you would have at that point. Holy shit, I wasn't even looking at health. So much damage. Yeah, well, you can't really do the Sage Cheese because you wouldn't be able to get Storytellers on that run, right? Like, unless you just got super lucky. Right? Forgot to put the ring on. Start with a fire gem? Maybe you would start with the fire gem. That's what I was thinking, actually. Like, I was kind of thinking you just, like, get as many souls as possible at the start of the game. So you, like, you kill the sword master, get the two embers in shrine, get the serpent ring, like, get everything you can for souls. Like, get to as high as the level as possible. I don't know. I feel like if we did that run, it would take, like, the work of everybody here. Like, because we would need to think of so many things. Like, that, like, I don't know if I'd be able to do that by myself. Get 3 or 4 shots at... Yeah. No, you could... I don't even know if you'd have three or four. You'd probably have two. Actually, no, I guess you could kill some later ones, yeah. Bonus NPCs? Yeah, you could. You could get a heavy gem early if that was useful. Although, I don't know if it would be because, like, you need the Farron Coal. So, I think you would, a fire gem start would be the way. Start as assassin with fire gem. Maybe buy the short sword. Infuse that. You could technically get Henri straight sword if you wanted to. Like for Wolnir. I don't know, that run would be a huge, huge project. Like, bigger than anything I've ever done, easily. It'd be kind of cool, though. And then there would need to be a good strat for high wall. With, like, even with the dragon aggroed. So that would need to exist. Aggro dragon cheese? Probably not. I don't know if there's anything you can really do about him. Arrow cheese? No, I probably wouldn't go through the work of killing him. I'd probably just, like, figure out a way to run past him every time. Can't reset enemies? Yep, that's true. Well, whenever you go back to shrine, you'd reset them, right? Like that's when you would have the reset. Reset a Wolnir summon? Oh, definitely not. No, no, no. I would try to survive the Wolnir summon easily. Like, I wouldn't even homeward bone a Wolnir summon now, so. Like, on a run where I just need to go back to Abyss Watcher's bonfire. Cost of a reset super high? Yeah, I guess, yeah. I mean, but that's what the run would be like, though. You couldn't avoid that. Okay, staff time. Okay, I gotta get the coins over here. And so I guess technically, if you guess on 1 and 2, you have a higher chance than any other guess to get it. But not by much. I don't think it gives much item discovery. Yeah, but the thing about that run, like, you could still get damage on it. Like, that's the thing. Like, you could still get good damage for dancers, still get good damage for, like, deacons and stuff. Like, it's just you need to minimize how many times you go back to Shrine. But you could go back to Shrine as many times as you want, technically, as long as you can get back to where you were. ODK. ODK wouldn't be on the run. It'd just be any percent. I while second pass would be manageable. Great items and stats. Yeah, no, that's true. It is true. Like, there's definitely a way you can get by it. Yeah, no, Cyros. Yeah, no, like, it's just any percent. There's no way I'd do more content than that. Okay, let's buy the stuff first this time. Oops. Alright, guess time. Everybody guess. Actually, I have souls left. I should buy stuff. Sure. Yeah, so like I said, we're gonna use the coins on the first two attempts. So that is, like, statistically, or I guess numerically, you'd have the highest chance if you guessed on one and two. So I'm gonna guess two. I'm gonna guess two. Item discovery doesn't go up that much, but it still goes up, so. When I don't have Dark Sign equipped. It's two times. No, it's not two times. It's like 50. It's like an additional 50 item discovery or something. Like, it's not really significant. New any percent route stops at plus three Onris, straight sword. Yeah, was that? That's like teardrop and stuff, right, though? Okay, I was wrong. Skittle, what's up, dude? How are you, man? Two more tries burn, so you think number four? I've gotten it right twice. And so then the other two have gotten it is you burn, and then Krogan has gotten it as well. Correct. All right, turn number four. You were feeling it? He had Olin over. Is that a joke? Is that real? Please tell me that's real. If that was real, that would be just the best thing. Oh, it is real. No way. I need to see that. If he's streaming, we're definitely hosting him tonight. I've lost count, by the way, so. See if it's real for yourself. Not fake news. I trust iframes, so. Not that I don't trust other people. It's just like, iframe says it's real. That's awesome, actually. I want to see that really badly. Yeah, Skittle, it's not like I don't trust you. I'm just... Drop your stupid staff. Still don't trust him. Oof. That's rough. Can't always trust Twitch chat. But how can I trust what you just said? Like, what if you're lying? Coins are useless, that's correct. And that's why when people said them at the beginning, I'm like, I guess we can try them, but yeah, coins won't do much. Well, coins, can, like, they only last one go, right? Like, as soon as you homeward bone, their use has been exhausted. So. Okay, what am I not building right now? Walter, what's up, dude? How are you, man? Gold ones are pretty good for item farming. Yeah, but if you have a bunch of them, then yeah, they would be good. But oh, good thing. I hate that guy so much. I should firebomb that guy or something. I should definitely firebomb that guy. Flynn's is what I don't have on. Okay, I don't need that equipped. Not a scrub. Look, swish an eye up. I don't think that'd be a good idea. I don't think so. McRaptor, what's up, man? Dude, insane job with the turn move, by the way, man. I watched a little bit of the last one. That was really cool. Good idea. I think people really liked it, actually. Like, I've heard a lot of stuff about it. Okay, so this will be actually a little interesting. I might have to free aim this. Thank you. Oh, what? Who did I just... Ba-ba-ba. I don't know who I just hit there. Or did I hit that? Oh, I hit the archer in the back. That was funny. I didn't even consider hitting that dude. Yeah, normal firebombs are not ideal there. Like, you want the black for the extra range. Why are you asking Neon if you want to go to bed, Walter? What is that supposed to mean, man? Oh, this part of the this run's so boring until you get to like DLC stuff. Like, that's why I like the no upgrade run so much better. You broke your right alt key. Trying to learn fair and keep skip. Dang, that's... I don't know, if I ever did speedruns, I probably wouldn't be... Like, I'd... Probably try to do no major skips. Just so I don't have to do that. But maybe. I don't know. Not out of the question, and I do want to do speedruns eventually. Mez, welcome back, dude. Thanks for the hosts. How are you? I wonder if buffing would be worth it here. I do have a resin. Probably not, like it. We do enough damage to this guy. Compared to the like 90 damage we get on no upgrade. You're investing now pretty long, fun learning them? See, that's actually what I like about these runs the most, is like learning stuff, figuring it out. It's like maybe I'll like that, but it looks painful. Like I was watching someone learn them, or learn fair and keep skip. And it looked bad. Like, it looked very hard to do. But I still think I'd do no major skips though. Run's going well. Well, we're still in the first little bit of it, but I guess we haven't gotten hit yet, so. How many controllers and keyboards have died to the Dark Souls gods? Well, mine has, but I'm still using it. And it's actually killed some runs, too. So. Like, so my right bumper doesn't always work, and then that's the, like, the biggest issue, but then my... my B button kind of gets stuck sometimes, but that hasn't been an issue yet. New Wilhelm skip. I still haven't seen that skip yet. Like, I've heard a lot about it. I still haven't seen it. Okay, wait, so do you guys want me to explain this as we go? Anybody comic? Yeah, okay, I'll do it. Sticky? No, it's like, it's not sticking. Okay, so basically here. What we're gonna do to start this is we're gonna take them around to the back. And it's just, it's easier for the phase two. When we fight the Archdeacon, so no other, like, deacons are shooting at us when we're trying to kill him. So that's phase, this is like the first step of the strat here. Very simple. And you can see, so it switches deacons, the orb. And so it does it every 26 seconds, which is very important for this. And so just like this, I don't know. I kind of came up with this from trial and error, but we're going to try to run to the other side when it switches deacons again. So it'll probably be like 10 seconds from now or less. So whenever it switches, that's when we're going to run to the other side. So it just did. So now this timing kind of works out so that we're going to get some damage in phase two. And this is more important for no upgrade, where we don't get a lot of damage. And so yeah, we're going to cast a Storyteller's Weapon Art, which is going to hit the Deacon in there. And I'll count out loud. So it's on the first Deacon right now. We don't have to worry about much. We don't need to count or anything. So it just switched. So I'll count on this one. So right as it lands. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. Okay, so I'm counting a little slow, but so now is when I actually need to start counting. So we're past the threshold now, and we're at like the 20-second mark. So now I'm going to run over. And so now you'll hear the orb switch. Just did. And now we're right here for phase two. Yeah, so when it switches, I run to the other side. And like, I don't know if I explained it like super well there, but like, you do need to count so that you go over at the right time. But yeah, it is always 26 seconds. It's just like, the reason I go over at 20 is because I know my counting's not going to be perfectly accurate. Seems less cheesy. Yeah, no, well, you still get phase two. Like, it's, I don't know. Yeah, that's what it is. Very, like, it's pretty simple. Like, coming up with it was a little bit more tricky with just the timings and stuff. But I was so surprised when I learned that, first of all, that the timings weren't randomized when it tried to switch deacons. And then next, that it, phase two was actually triggered not by like a specific amount of damage, but by when you're past an amount of damage and then the orb tries to switch deacons. Like, that was very surprising. I'm not void zone. This doesn't matter. So 26 seconds between orbs. Start counting when you realize in your 1400 and they switched. Yeah, so like, I didn't need to count The second last one. Like, I only did it to kind of demonstrate. I'm shitty at this game. So bad. Terrible at this game. But yeah, so like, you just want to make sure that it doesn't, like, get to 1400 and then switch. Like, because that's what you need to be aware of. So it's when it lands on the deacon, kind of. It's not right immediately when it switches, when you start counting. But yeah, so like, if you recognize that it's like when the next switch is going to happen, it's going to be past 1400 damage, then that is when you want to start counting and then head over to the other side at 20 seconds. That's kind of scary, actually. I didn't need to throw a firebomb there. Yeah, so you want to go to the other side when you get to 20 seconds, basically. And you're past the 1400 damage, and then the orb's going to switch. Like, so at 20 seconds. That's when you want to go over to the other side. And so, like, the way I do it there at the beginning, like, doing that little bit of delay and waiting until the orb switches to run over to the other side and then cast the weapon art, that'll make it so it'll take three more swaps to start phase two. And so that way you kind of... It almost maximizes the amount of damage you'll get with the poison before phase two actually starts. Because it's different every time, right? Like, and that was the thing that shocked me the most about that strat at first. Need max damage? No. Well, we do it on the no upgrade right away, right? Like, you don't need a ton of damage. But if you don't have this much damage, then you're going to need skulls, basically. Like, so I think, like, with any upgraded weapon, you'll probably need one skull. Like, any, like, plus four weapon. If you have an unupgraded weapon that's not Frostbite, then you're going to need more than that. You might need, like, three-ish. Like, on the no upgrade, since we get Frostbite, we only need one. But, like, one cuts it close, sort of. Yeah, so. Like, you just need to test it out. Need max... Oh, no, definitely not. Like, you have time to get, like, five hits there. Like, if you have enough stamina, you can get five hits. Like, if you have the straight sword or something. Yeah, basically the only requirement for that strat is 12 intelligence, like, and the storyteller staff. And then if you need them, if you don't have enough damage. But I honestly feel like if you did it on SL1 with +9 broadsword, raw broadsword, and then you just like buff it before you go in there, you could probably do it without skulls also. Not entirely sure about that, but like, if I did choose to do my SL1 runs with storytellers, then yeah. Okay, so we need patches now. I think you should pair this strat with Pyro. You can if you want. See, like, with Pyro, you can do it with Poison Mist or whatever it's called, Toxic Mist. And I think it has the exact same effect. I'm pretty sure it's very, like, the same It's like the same effect, basically, I'm pretty sure. So I think you could probably do it with that to skip having to do the farming. Except I don't know where you would get toxic mist. Can I use staffs? Yeah, but you can, like I said, you can use toxic mist. Like that is a viable substitute. If you can get it, I just don't know where that spell is though, or like how you get it. Or no, can't you just get it from the pyromancy guy? Like, I don't even know if you need a tome for that. Maybe you do. But yeah, you get it from him, so you can just... you can just do that. Like, I'm pretty sure you get it from him. Forget his name, but... in the demon runes? Well, if you did Couch's routing, you would go down there anyway, right? Because he goes down there. Let's get some lows. Maybe in the lava? I don't think so. I think you can buy it for him from the guy. Oh, whoops. Yeah, no, I'm sure if you just like wiki how to, or just search up how to get that spell, like it'll tell you what tome you need. And I'm sure like he already gets the tome, so. Great great swamp pyromancy tome. So is that the one in Farron Keep? Because yeah, you definitely get that. Or is there one in Farron Keep? I don't know. I don't know much about spells or whatever, but yeah, like I'm sure it's already available on that run. DLC so early? Well, I'd mainly do it to get the running sections out of the way, but it's really not that early. Like, look at our stats. We have, what, 52 dex plus 9 weapon? It's really not that early. Run to Demon Prince? Yeah, it kind of is. Just one part. Just the second, or the angel, whatever. I should rest. Nope. I remembered. Get wrecked, game. Oh, it still got me. Oh. My brain cells. Sage Ring is a bitch to get, though. Is it? I don't know. That's the one in Crucifixion Woods, like near the cross, dude. Jesus guy. Yeah, he's next to Ape Jesus, man. And the little crabs. Unfollow, unsub. What, for the noise? Revolution, what's up, dude? Welcome back. Yeah, this is a new playlist. It's not the typical, like, just pure lo-fi. Sorry, Wilhelm. Didn't mean to punch you, my good friend. Oh, sorry, Wilhelm. Didn't mean to punch you again, my good friend. Oh, sorry, Wilhelm. Asshole. Did I? Oh, what did... Where is he at? Oh, there he goes. Okay. Mobile 30 seconds behind. Mobile Monk S. Yeah, mobile is trash. It's like, I wish it was good, but it is hard for something like that to be good. Like, not even just because of, like, the latency, but because of... just the whole setup. Run across the bridge at the beginning? Yeah, you can do that. It's just there's no use in doing that right now. Like, I don't need to open the door before Frida. And like, I'll do it later when I have to go to Gravetender. Dog, you can't walk away from me, boy. Get that shit out of here. Scary as fuck. It's actually not that bad. I mean, maybe. It's actually pretty consistent, though. I missed your question. Where's your question? Oh, why backstab with the dagger punished with the Earthless Straight Sword? So dagger does the highest backstab damage I can do at that point. And then Earthless Straight Sword... does the highest physical damage I can do at that point. And so just that combination just ends up doing the most damage you can on Abyss Watchers and like any other backstab. No. And so it's the highest damage I can get. Because I can get a full charge R2 off with the straight sword and then... yeah. Skipped on purpose? Nah, I just didn't see it. Feel free to... yeah, we will this time. Hopefully. But yeah, we're like, we Like I said, this run's... Oh, that's so bad. No. That's terrible. Oh, he's about to spit. Oh, wait. Oh, he's spitting at me. Just kidding. Trying to bleed watchers? With what? There's no way. There's... No. No, I don't think that'd be the right course of action. That guy's a higher crit modifier? Or hit him with crit modifier? Yeah, no, I noticed that when I... Like, originally I was using the rapier. When I got the any percent run, I was using the rapier for backstabs, thinking since it had higher crit multiplier and higher physical damage that it would be better for backstabs. But it's actually not, because all daggers have that, like, the extra backstab damage. Bleed useful anywhere on this. On this particular run, not really. Like, on the... No upgrade it is. Only on Dancer, basically. Not really on this run, though. Okay, get that Onyx Blade out of here. I don't want that shit. What weapon do I use on Dancer? I use Reinforced Club. It's pretty good. I cheese halfway. This is the hardest fight? Definitely not. No, definitely not. Easy. So it should have went the first time. Is that execution attack high damage or insta-death? Which attack do you mean? Not entirely sure what you're getting at. Alright, for Demon Prince, phase two, we're gonna use the buff. I think. Alright, Burn. Have a good sleep, dude. Thanks for hanging out, man. I'll see you next time. He dashed in, I slit my throat. Oh. No, it's not an insta-kill. It's on me, it would be, obviously. But. If you have high enough health and good armor, you should be able to survive that. So now, so we have a slab. What, like, one good thing about doing Frida early is that we get a slab. Early slab, which is good for everything. Because normally we don't get plus 10, on the ending percent until after after Dragon Slayer, right? So, we have that. I don't think we need anything here. Oh, we don't have skulls though. I should get some skulls for after. Plus 10. Yeah, early plus 10, exactly. Hopefully we get to Yorm so you guys can see the Yorm strat on this run. It's ridiculous. Okay, so we should get some more endurance for this fight, probably. Up to 20. Loot the Ring City? What do you mean loot? Like, I run through it. So I get the running section out of the way early. What's the Yorm strat? We don't use Storm Ruler on this run. No Storm Ruler. Okay, don't need this on anymore. Get Titanite from there? No, we don't. We don't do that. You bastard. Oh, double kill. GG. Well done. I didn't even need to lift a finger. Where do I get the scales from? Well, I don't need scales on this run. Like, we don't need anything from Ring City. I don't pick anything up. I don't think. Like, we just need to get through it. Basically. Okay, so as soon as we kill the first demon, then we'll switch from Chlorinthy into Pontiffs. Friendly fire. Indeed. It's also very convenient. Scales up in the whole run? Like in the whole game, you mean? Like I don't know. Unfortunate. kind of nice when that fight's not a 20-minute fight, actually. Neon, if you're still here, dude, have a good sleep. Thanks for the good luck. Yeah, that fight, I mean... Get good damage, man. Easy, 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 easy. Colmer? Colmer, what's up, man? Thanks for the host, dude. How was the stream? Bend over. That's creative. What's up, dude? Welcome. Colmer, thanks for the host, dude. How was the stream? Eldebar, welcome back, dude. What's up? Fabs two traps. Hey, man. Welcome back, dude. Do we need anything here? I guess we can level up endurance, maybe. Stream too late for you to chat. You've been loving the runs. Thanks, dude. I appreciate that a lot, actually. Thank you very much. Maxwell, hey man, what's going on? Okay, so I guess we don't really need skulls in this DLC. We need, or for this running section anyway. Get some endurance. That's a lot of damage. Now that's a lot of damage. Two hit PB, Bloodborne, any percent. Oh boy. Nice, dude. Very well done, man. I'm so excited to play that game. It's gonna be great. Yeah, but GG, man. Two hits, that's pretty serious. That's grind territory. I should really have a split that's just, like, Ring City or something. Because this running section's kind of long. Well, it's not super long, it's, like, significant. One of them was frenzy buildup because you were reading chat. Dang. I mean, at least that's like an easy fix, right? And they read chat and shouldn't. Yeah, that's happened to me a few times. Especially in Deacons, like specifically Deacons, that's happened to me. To keep focused on Deacons. Yeah, Deacons is kind of like, it's so easy to just start thinking about stuff. Okay, I think we're good on items right now, so I shouldn't really need bones. If I do, I've got bones, so Okay. Special strat for Deacons? Yeah, that's true. Doesn't really take much focus until I need to start counting, but it's not hard to keep focus when I'm doing that. Kill the second Dragon Slayer? Nah. No point. Fat, dumb, and doofus? Thanks, dude. Nice name. The Red Cyndaquil? Have a good sleep, dude. Hopefully I said that right. Alright, let's do this part. I went so... I timed that, like, as soon as you could possibly go. That was really close, actually. Like, I was so early when he started flying. I got so much time. Freed or Frida? I say Frida, but I... Like, Freed is reasonable also. I'm used to that part taking like 10 minutes, or not 10 minutes, like 6 minutes with Irithyll Straight Sword unupgraded. Man. Just stupid damage. Alright, Pontiff time. Angry Dragon to Dead Dragon in 10 seconds. Basically, like, all it took was one cycle of the neck hits where that do the extra damage and instantly dead. What I might want to do is... Okay, we've got skulls, actually. What do I need? I don't need anything, do I? This is weird. I feel like I need stuff. Guess I leveled up before. Through a temper tantrum. Well, that's what he does when he gets to, like, I think it's half health. But like, so that's kind of like the moment, like, you're like, okay, he's half health or whatever. But it happens so quickly in this, like, it's ridiculous. Okay, I think I remember Pontiff. Hopefully. I don't have any fire bundles, but probably don't need any. Parry him or fight him the hard way? I used to fight him the hard way, but now I parry just because on other runs, like the no upgrade run, like I parry, like I need to. And so I just want to stay consistent with the other runs. Oh, I wasn't even wearing Chloranthi plus 3 there. Whoops. Okay, we don't need that. I actually want to get rid of normal Chloranthi. Get the run yesterday? Nah, we didn't get the run yesterday. See, like, how could I fight him the other way when you could just do that to him? Mixing up, yeah, a little bit, I guess. Where'd he go? Not exactly. Like, when you're doing that much damage, like, it's just crazy. Like, plus 10 weapon on Pontiff, that's what you get. And, like, you could have Hornet Ring, too, if you had Hornet Ring, and, like, that would just be disgusting. Safer to parry his other attacks? I like parrying the other ones better. Yeah. Like, especially that one. That one's a good parry move. I'm happy I didn't forget to grab those. Parry Champ Gundyr? Yeah. Yeah, but we're also going to use the Storyteller on him. So, it'll probably only take, like, one or two parries against him. But we'll see. See when we get there. But I think normally it's 3 parries against him. Used to Gwyn coming at you from a football field away. It was more natural. I guess that's fair, yeah. Okay, we actually need to go back to shrine here. I need homework bones. Storyteller only, no hit. Nope, that's not possible. Unless you use like spells or something.
I guess it would be.
This run feels so much faster than... Or maybe slower. I don't know, like if... When we get an hour and 50 minutes into the other run, it feels like it takes so much longer than this one. Like this run, it just flies by almost. Like I guess because we're killing bosses that quickly. Why is it impossible? Well... Like unless you use spells, because this is not a weapon, right? It's a staff. So like hitting things with it isn't very good. Homer bones. Guess we might as well level up. Maybe, like, we don't really need endurance for anything, but. Farewell, Ashen One. Yeah, so what I really like about the routing of this run and the order we do things, like a lot of the running sections are out of the way already, like Ring City, like that's a big one. So like once we get to that point, once we get to Grave Tender, then there's no more running sections left in the game basically. Oh, I don't have bundles either, man. Okay, we'll just... Is Aldrich weak to lightning? I think so, right? Does anyone know? Taking notes on Aldrich? This is not a good run to learn on Aldrich. It's really not. Like, we kill him too quickly. I think he's weak to lightning. Pretty sure. Yeah, this is not a good run to watch to learn what we do for Aldrich. Like, you would probably gain more from watching the no upgrade Aldrich because that's... That's the, like, that's the run where you actually need to take an account phase 2. But I guess on this run, you don't really need to. Taking notes on everything, you're gonna attempt any percent soon? Fair enough. So basically what you want in phase 1 is to do less than 1600 damage. And then wait for a teleport and then wait for an opening. I usually wait for the best move and then a lot of times you can just skip phase 2. I need to not do too much damage here. That's probably good. Good move in my books. That's what I get. That's what I get for missing a hit. Almost like ROM. Yeah, I guess it's kind of similar. Except you don't need to deal with like spiders or anything. Any like trash mobs. Yeah, that was just completely my fault. I'm not used to the range of this weapon. Like, with a straight sword, that would have hit, probably. So that's kind of what I'm used to. I also didn't even put the right ring on there. I'm supposed to have Pontiffs. Probably don't need it, though. When I have a plus 10 weapon. ...1060 damage before she starts to teleport. You need about 960 to guarantee the quick kill. Honestly, that doesn't mean that much to me because I haven't played Bloodborne yet, so... I've never fought against Rom. Although I've seen lots of Rom fights. And I just wasted a bundle that I wanted to use on Yorm, so. Yeah, I don't have a PS4. Unless I would definitely have Bloodborne by now. Probably would have no-hit it already, too. Ooh, I need to watch out the damage. Okay, good thing only one of my blades hit there. Actually, that would have been probably the correct amount of damage. Yeah, so that's what this fight is, basically. Not even a phase 2. People use Fire Bundle Aldrich. Lightning's actually just a better damage type. It actually does more damage, but the reason I used Lightning is because I didn't want to go back to Shrine and I didn't have any fire. No frame drops, yeah, that's true. I've got the skulls. Comic, thanks for those, man. Yeah, like, we did more than enough damage there. Like, easily got the kill. Not even at 2 hours yet. What song is this? Let me check. It is Wildfire by Vancouver Sleep Clinic. Also, Patriot Ninja, what's up, dude? How are you? Yeah, so even though the splits say we're not halfway through the run yet, we are definitely halfway through. More than halfway. Level? Plus 10, 55 dex. Sharp infused. Get the running parts out of the way first because they're more consistent. Well, it's actually like it's. Well, it's because they're less consistent, right? Like, I want to get the least consistent stuff out of the way earlier. Or the hardest stuff out of the way earlier. So that's why. That's why I do, like, running sections first, or try to. Just because usually bosses, like... Bosses are usually... like, if you don't make a mistake, you're fine, but some running sections aren't quite like that. Ooh, he actually aggroed there. Ran a little bit too far. Hardest boss to no hit? Well, it depends, to be honest. It depends what you allow yourself to use. Without Storyteller Staff, hardest boss to no hit is Half Light. With Storyteller Staff as an option, like with Twin Blades. Oh, I don't know. Like, it's really... It's probably Cinder. Probably still Cinder, even. I guess we'll get these equipped now. Oh, I could level up too, so we might as well do that when we get to Profaned Capital. Like this route? Like, do you mean the order of bosses? Yeah. Yeah, I came up with it. I mean, it's something that can still, it's like still subject to change. It's not like, it's not set in stone or anything. Just whatever I feel like doing, basically. Like, but it is favoring getting the running sections early, out of the way early. Oh, you know what? We're not going to set up our T-Star. We probably don't even need it. I think this is what I did last time also. Because I don't remember the RTSR setup here. What I used to do was set it up with the Toxic. I used to get the Excrement-covered Ashes and then give myself Toxic and then use the Blooming Moss Clump, but... Never seen Frieda and Demon Prince done so early. Yeah, it kind of makes sense. Like, they're not... It's not like I'm doing them with, like, minimal stats. Like, I still have a plus 9 weapon for Frieda and, like, 60... Or, like, 50 decks. Like, it's not... It's not bad at all.
Farewell, Ashen One.
Yeah, and then Demon Prince, like, we still have a plus 10 weapon, so it's not like we're doing them with bad damage or anything. It doesn't make them harder doing them earlier. It's just a different way of doing things. Probably not that big of a leap. It's not a big deal. Not a big deal at all. And I think for the strat, it actually doesn't change anything, maybe. We'll see. Poison Pyromancy? It's Toxic Mist. Oh no! That's not too much. Kind of forgot what I was supposed to do there. Let's see. Messed up a little bit. Yeah, so I messed up the strat there a little bit. What it's supposed to be is I guess it doesn't really make a difference, honestly. But basically, the strat I'm supposed to do is uses the Storm Ruler to get the kill, but I'm not supposed to see any of Phase 2, but that works. Yeah, with RTSR, you can get 16,000 damage on the, like, riposte combo. Let's get to that, and then... Oh, I guess we're going to Dragonstar, aren't we? I forget that we do Dragonstar now. Forgot Dragonstar existed, to be honest.
Farewell, Ashen One.
Oh right, I'm not in this mode. How many tries to get storytellers this time? I don't even remember, to be honest. I think it was like probably 15. Miss Yorn fight? It's not really a big deal. You just don't fight him with Storm Ruler. It's the only difference. Oh, I can't discard that. What a mistake. Hopefully I got the elevator. I think I did. See, because I'm so used to doing early Dragon Slayer, I just forgot about this stuff. What else do I do? Well, you hit his right arm, so his weapon arm with Twin Blades plus 10, this amount of dex, you can stagger him in 3 hits to that, and then you can get 3 hits off with a bundle to his head, which do insane damage, and then riposte. So strat honestly seems way safer. If you're comfortable with dodging the staggers, then yeah, it's definitely safer. But the thing is, most no hit runners don't know how to, like, can't react fast enough to that, just because when you use Storm Ruler, you never see it. You never see the staggers that he does. So, and if you do, normally you get hit. But I've fought against Yorm a lot without Storm Ruler, so. Okay, I forget how this fight goes. I'm not gonna go for greed though. That's the biggest thing. Have to see that. Well, he did it probably 5 times there. He did like 5 staggers, so. Such skiller, is that a joker? This fight on this run does not require much skill, to be honest. If I have fire bombs, we can just go right away to do. Obliterated that boy? Yeah, no, he's... It's a lot more impressive to do that fight on no upgrade, because it's phase 2 is long. Like, doing it this way, there's no phase 2. It just doesn't exist, so. When the storyteller stops, strats, man. Great. This is great. Might look boring, but this is actually fantastic. I hate killing this sage with twin blades. 2 hours on SL1. Yeah, no, when you have this kind of damage, it's not hard. How much playtime do I have in a DS3? It's between 900 and 1,000 hours. Around. Probably closer to 1,000. But I don't know exactly. Hey, how far are we into this? 212. SL1 no upgrade? Yeah, that's bad. That's gonna be hard to no hit that. SL1 no upgrade, but we did it first try last time, so. A lot of hours. Yeah, there's people in this game who have like thousands of hours, like 2,500 hours, 3,000. Maybe I'll get to that point eventually. And hopefully when I do, I have a few more runs under my belt. Maybe we don't need this. He's got around 3,000. Yeah, that honestly doesn't surprise me. He knows so much about this game. It's crazy. As well. The extra souls. Poison mist. Oh, are they different spells? I didn't even realize they were different. Yeah, poison mist would work also, but I'd imagine it does less damage because poison is worse than toxic, but I didn't realize that there were two. But usually, like, that resistance on bosses goes hand in hand. Like, it's if a boss is resistant to poison, they are resistant to toxic. Test that? I don't know. Like, I don't really... Like, that wouldn't really give me any more knowledge on anything that's useful. Ooh, do I have enough skulls here? Okay, we use... One, two, three, four. Okay, we're good. Yeah, no, I like toxic does more damage. Like to the character at least. Like it ticks for a lot more. But I don't know if it's the exact same effect as storytellers. Like I'm sure it is. I'm sure it has the same amount of range also. Yeah, no, the weapon art doesn't actually, weapon art doesn't affect you. I don't know about the actual spells, but for sure the weapon art doesn't. All right, Colmer, see you later, man. Thanks again for the host, dude. I'll see you next time. Okay, I can't forget to get the sharp gem up here. Very important. Hawk, what's up, dude? Welcome back. I will hit him with normal firebomb, I guess. I could do the strat with the demon or whatever, or the gargoyle, but I'd rather not. Yeah, this sharp gem is pretty essential. Upgrade is essential, I think. No upgrade run? Well, I mean, for the strats on this run, it's essential. Like, they don't work if we don't have the upgrades. Okay, let's go to Shrine Axe. We have a lot of levels. Dia Onion. Hopefully I said that right. Thanks for the good luck, dude. How are you? We don't really need anything besides levels, I guess. Okay, we are almost at the max dex that we can reach until after Grave Tender. Fairly close. So we can't get past 66 dex for Grave Tender, or else the strat doesn't work. I'm thinking about ODK right now. I don't know whether we should, like, the strat with Twin Blades, I absolutely hate, like, with the insta-kill. I, like, despise that. So. Ooh, I don't really have buffs for this, do I? Okay, we'll use fire. Maybe Pale Pine. Actually, no, Pale Pine's not good. We'll just use fire for phase 2. You don't really need it phase 1, I don't think. Yeah, it kind of sucks that I didn't, like, think about buying more, but whatever. The length of that entire fight is like the length of 3/4 of phase 1 on the no upgrade. Okay, I guess we're going to shrine, kill Cinder. No memes. Yeah, see, that's the thing about this run. I'm fine with doing it normal because the fight lasts such a short amount of time. There's not a lot of room for that kind of stuff to happen. Guess we don't need this, do we? So he just said fuck when, like, when I guess I skipped the dialogue fast, so it probably sounded like it. Let's buy some dark human pine resin. Wanted to do it. That's not good. That's not good. I guess we'll get a little bit. Like, we don't really need much more endurance. But I guess we can get to 65. Also use that. Summary of the adaptation of my Deacon strat for Pyro. Oh, so you, did you like test stuff out? King of Dimes, what's up, dude? Come on, I'm standing on the air. Thank you. We don't really need Pontus Red Eye. If I remember, I'll switch to in phase two, but I probably won't. Doesn't really make a huge difference. Easy. Ex-Archer, thanks, dude. I appreciate that, man. Okay, we need some... Okay, I have the lightning for Osiris. Do you have... Well, it honestly doesn't feel hard because when... I'm so used to no upgrade cinder that lasts like 15 minutes. And... Like, I see that scenario where, like, soul mass and stuff, like, I see that, like, 7 times. So, like, on this run, it's not really a big deal because we only see it once. Okay. Ashen one. Apple. Buzzy, what's up, dude? Okay, we're not gonna level anything, no?
Ashen one.
When he heals for no upgrades. Honestly, I usually stagger him out of it. Like, cause I use Black Knight Halberd, so it staggers him pretty well. I guess we're going to dance or bonfire. Edgy meme's supposed to be Abyss Watchers? Well, it's everything up to Wolnir. So once we kill Wolnir, that's when I split that. Because they're like kids. They are basically, so yeah. Only 2.5 hours. We still have like an hour of this left. Romeo, what's up, dude? How are you, man? Okay, I do have skulls, which is important here. Night boy. Ooh. Right in the nutsack. What do you need to keep in mind before you try the poison toxic mist? I don't think anything. You just gotta test it out. Ooh, I should actually have some bundles, maybe. Whatever. Easy, easy, easy. Dodge the instant charges. So basically you need to know every single possible chance that it can come, and you need to roll as if he's doing the instant charge every single time. And that's how you dodge it. So like there's a lot of panic rolling that it looks like on this fight, but really you have to play like every single chance that he can do the insta charge. You have to play like he is doing the insta charge. Nerf wind blades? Yeah, no, that's, well, I guess you guys, like those of you who have been watching the no upgrade stuff, like you understand the pain. 70% of his health gone in seconds. Yeah, I even messed it up too. I should have killed him earlier. I missed one hit there, but yeah. Parry, yeah, we're gonna parry Gundyr. I do want to try the storyteller staff thing though, so we're gonna test it out. Upgrade infusion, whole other world, exactly. Yep. That's a joke. I didn't even light this, did I? See, how, like, why was he able to aggro to me there? So now we don't have RTSR because of that. How important is dexterity? Well, we are using a sharp weapon, so it has increased dexterity scaling. And then we also, these weapons just scale with dex very well. So. Instant charge for 3 to 5 minutes, yeah. Must be terrible. It is kind of terrible, but we have frostbite, so it's not as bad. Don't hit a fat parry on Gundy. Gun dry. I will try, but now we don't have RTSR, so. Then you studied dragons for, or too hard? Yeah, I guess so, yeah. Yeah, I'm not sure why he aggroed last time. That's like, it's really annoying. It might mean an extra parry, but whatever. Oh, and we insta-kill him, even without RTSR, man. Get out of here. See if I can get the no damage here. Nope. Okay, let's see. Let's try to get storytellers on him. Oh, I hit the wrong button. For fun. Get wrecked, boy. Did we get the souls? I think we did. Let's get Hornet Ring. Head to Archdragon Peak. Plus, we finally get Clothed Sword Fragment, which is great. Because we have to do something in Archdragon Peak that requires lots of Homeward Bones, potentially, so. Compared to you, or compared to me, you're trash. Well, I mean, you think about how much time I put in this game. Like, I've put almost 1,000 hours into this game. So, like, and specifically just to do this stuff. Oh, I hate when I do that. I stopped a little bit too early, and like, you just kind of don't want to walk too quickly. Okay, so we are going to get some lightning resins. Okay, we can't level up yet. What's that clip do? You touched his ass? Probably. I have the desire to. Oh, the end of the champ fight. Okay. Imagine if I missed that. Imagine. For fun. Dead. Rip run. That would have been clipped too. I guess so. Okay, let's get these Xanthus ashes. We're gonna wait until these next two get passed as well. How much do I enjoy doing this right now? It's pretty good. I like getting on good runs. And I've kind of forgotten about how easy this game can be when you're actually like leveling up stuff. Like, it's definitely something you take for granted until you can, like, you do a weapon, or you do a run where you're, like, SL1, for example, but if you want to take that further, then do no upgrade. Magic only run? I haven't really used magic in this game. Singa, what's up, dude? I'm pretty good, man. How are you? Oh, yeah, the half-life strat's gonna be spicy. Saying torture isn't bad until you start cutting off limbs? Well, unless you like cutting off limbs. Right? Please take damage. God damn it. Whoops. I set up. Slept like a rock. That's good, man. I never said I'd like cutting off limbs. I'm just... Hopefully we don't die from this. That'd suck. Ooh. Oh, how... Oh, let's... My friend's over there trying to help me. You guys didn't need to know that, but that's who he's shooting at, by the way. My summon. Just to show off, because running up is riskier. Wait, what do you mean? Like how I sat there at the end? I don't know. Satisfying. Susie, thanks for the good luck. How are you? Alright, let's get us some Dragon Chaser's Ashes. About to go to sleep, Susie? Alright. Thanks for stopping by. See you next time. Have a good sleep. Can have skulls, so we should be fine. I'm not sure if the rock dude died. I didn't hear myself get any souls, but yeah, he didn't. So he's probably gonna aggro again. Not a huge deal. Let's check another skull. Partnered and beat Froz in 2 weeks. Must be running high these days. Yeah, that's pretty sweet. It's a good gig. Not bad. So we don't really need lightning for phase one. Actually, might as well. Some of those for phase one.
Ashen One.
All right, Nameless King time, almost. Just need to set up RTSR. I actually used to not fight him with RTSR, and it was, like, still great. Insane damage, but I realize that there is a setup here. Story? Nah, he doesn't get poisoned. No upgrades to level 1, no hit runs. I've tried that for the any percent, and I got a 2-hit PB. I just haven't really worked on it since, so I'll probably do that eventually. Hopefully that's enough. Where's this guy? See my stats? Yeah, sure, dude. 66 dex, 30 endurance, 12 intelligence. That's the only thing I've leveled up. All right, let's do it. not quite, you guys, but I appreciate it. Easy. Yeah, no, like I'm telling you guys, this game with these weapons is kind of broken. Like, it's not that I'm making it look easy, it's just that it actually is. Like, when the fights are that short, like, it's not too bad. All right, let's get the stuff. Let's do it. It is time.
Pretty.
We have so many souls left over. Okay, so we're gonna get the 14 strength, man. That's the strat, 1466 strat.
Ashen one.
Okay, also ring setup's extremely important, but not yet. And we need skulls. Time is 2:57. Yeah, so we get strength there because, like, it still has a little bit, It does scale with strength still, and that one extra, or two extra AR that we get from strength actually, gives us the perfect amount of damage for this fight. Other people's perspectives? Well, no, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying, if you put this much time into these things, like, it should look like this. And it most likely will, and especially if you're using these weapons when you've come out from doing a run that you do, like, a quarter of the damage. Anyone can do it. Literally anybody can do it, so that's kind of my point. Alright, grave tender time. Am I writing a thesis? Well, it's not like... I know, it's not really like that. Like, I do put a lot of focus into this. I'm not gonna risk firebomb to start the fight. Because the damage is so precise. I can't risk it. Thank you. He waited a long time to do that one. I will say that. Okay, so I'm gonna ODK. So we're gonna do safe strats ODK. AKA Storytellers phase one. Now the easy boss? Not necessarily, actually. ODKs can actually be annoying. And I don't like doing the insta-kill strat. Yeah, stupid hitboxes. Well, no. Like, ODK has really stupid hitboxes, actually. Like, once you get him into phase two, he can, like, hit you with the... with just touching you. And I really don't like that, so that's why I play him safe. And we're going all decks now. Tube is great. Well, not really, but still annoying. Actually, let's make it so that I don't need to come back here. How many firebombs do I have? Oh, I have actually. We're good. Alright, Singa. See you later, man. Good luck at work. Thanks for hanging out, dude. Time of this run afterwards? We're at 307 right now. It's a little bit slow. That's kind of expected when it's, like, I haven't... This is the first time back at this run in months, so... Like, I think over 2.5 months. Okay, we don't really need this. See, this is where having the toxic buildup, RTSR setups are like super good. Probably two more. Cast Storytellers? It doesn't work like that. Storytellers doesn't affect the caster, whatever. I don't know why I have these buffs here. Okay, yeah, so we're gonna get Storytellers and then play it safe. Yeah, no, he's resistant to poison, actually. It's just, you can get it at the start. If we don't get it, it's not a big deal. Yeah, no, I wanted to play that extremely safe. Like, that fight, it's actually very, very possible to get hit on that. And when you're doing that much damage, we only had to hit him like 5 times or something, so. Poison isn't worth it? Eh. Yeah, maybe not. It is nice to have the passive damage, though. Yeah, no, I think he just meant for that boss, and that, like, I don't disagree with that. On champ? I think it is, actually. It reduces the number of parries you need to do, so. Definitely worth it. Like, and we'd just be waiting there at the beginning of that fight anyway. Like, just waiting for the move, so. That's true. It is true. Neutered in 2 seconds. Yep, that's why we wait until now to do him, because he's basically free.
Ashen.
Guess we can level up. Getting emotes? Not sure, dude. Not sure.
Ashen 1.
Make boss weapons. Yeah, let me just whip out the no upgrade strats right now. With the staff on. So this is actually the first run that we do on this where we're actually using the staff. So I didn't used to use the staff on this run, so that's how. Like, I did the parry shot and I just messed it up. Seriously? Not cheese late time yet. We have to go through Madeir. I don't think I got the right angle last time. There it is. Throw bombs for that. It's because you can glitch through that wall like pretty often if you try to roll into it. So yeah, that's why I throw a firebomb. Yeah, and you will fall through the map and then instant death, so. Easy. Madeir does that one move where he shoots dark shit out of his mouth. It's awesome. Yeah, no, Madeir looks really cool. Very cool looking boss for sure. I kind of want Karth's Blood Realm. Yeah, and I thought he could have done the dregs there, but he decided not to, so that was kind of nice. We de-aggroed, actually. That's cool. Jesus Christ, man. The dialogue, so I tried to, like, I was getting ready to homeward bone in case my positioning was off. And so the dialogue, when the dialogue's there, he, like, you can't actually activate the, like, it does, like, a double input sort of thing. And so it did the backstep, which put me into the, okay, that's actually good to know. Jesus, man. The terms of the guardian goes for you. It's line of sight. So if you're not, if there's an obstruction between you and him, he won't aggro to you. Yeah, that's basically it. Let's not accidentally do that again. You guys will see in a sec. That's the first time that's ever happened, actually. Never really messed it up before. Just gotta trust the position. So I'll explain the strat as it happens. So basically, when I was doing this run and practicing half-light, I realized that if you're out of the, like, if there's an obstruction between you and the NPC in this fight, they won't aggro to you. Yeah, so just like this. So there's an obstruction, he can't see me, so he can't aggro. And I noticed this because, like, the position I went after I killed that first guy, I would run behind the pillar and I would just stand there. And then I realized that Half-Light wouldn't actually go for you. And it just so happens that the storyteller staff has enough range where this happens. And so he's not aggro to me. Yeah. And I found this strat originally for the no upgrade run, because there was no possible way to no hit Half-Light at the time. And then so I just tested a few things out with this strat, or with the storyteller staff, and then using some knowledge from doing the runs earlier, found out that you can do this. So yeah. And I haven't done it like that many times, but it requires no skill at all, so. Make toast? I guess so. And it does around 2,000 and like 70 damage or something, and then I'll cast it again. Requires no skill. That's not what I know. I mean, maybe I sound like that, but definitely requires skill. It's just mainly practice. Practice. So if you put like this amount of time into it, then you can definitely do this. They're inside each other? Yep. Yes, sir. Which is the hardest boss for this run, Insanity? Probably... On this particular run, it's probably... Like, I want to say Cinder, but... I really don't know. Okay, so Gale... I haven't fought against Gale with Storytellers and Twin Blades before. But I'm thinking what we're going to do is... We're not going to use poison for phase one. And then we'll get the Storyteller stuff in phase two. That's what I'm thinking.
Ashen one.
And then that'll carry us through the rest of the fight, basically. Beam princes aren't hard. They're kind of hard, but they're not the hardest, I'd say. Like, I don't know, on this run it's a little bit different because you're doing so much damage.
Ashen.
Oh, normal princes. Maybe they are. Is a cheese for princes? Yeah, there is. There is a cheese. It's not like, it's not a guarantee win, but... I don't know what to say, guys.
Congrats, we watched you on stream and I was pooping my pants.
Okay. I need to breathe, man. Pock, thanks for the sub, dude. You did not need to do that. And Zio, thanks for giving the sub to Comic. Thanks, dude. That's crazy. You guys don't need to be doing this in Sylvia. Thank you for the raid. Good timing, if I must say.
Breathing is for losers.
Oh boy, okay. Man. Oh man. What's next in Sandy? I don't know, man. I don't. As if, eh? They were trying this run again for the first time in. Like 2 months. Is it for like second try back? So next, I don't know, man. I don't know. I don't know, man.